expect during our IPE examination is one thing, all these elements means 18th group elements will show low melting point and boiling point. Low melting point and boiling point. The reason why the 18th group elements shows low melting point and low boiling point are all they are monoatomic elements or molecules. The number of atoms present in these molecules are only one. So means if I want to write helium, it represents molecule as well as atom. Whereas in case of oxygen, O stands for oxygen atom, whereas O2 stands for oxygen molecule. But in case of helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, HE, the symbol itself represents atom and molecule. Hence it is called as monoatomic element or monoatomic molecule. So all they are monoatomic elements or monoatomic molecules with filled electrons. Filled electrons. This is the reason why no inter electron attractions or no direct attractions expected in between the atoms or molecules, except less attractive dispersion forces. This is the reason why there is no strong attraction between one 18th group element with another 18th group element. Where there is no strong attraction between these two, they can easily, we can convert them into liquids and gases. Hence, they are having low melting point and low boiling point. So, this is about physical properties of 18th group elements. So, as we told you just now, all 18th group elements with more stable electron configuration, they never readily reacts with other elements. Here they are more stable and inert. Why they are more stable? It is explained with the concept of two conditions, that is having 8 electrons in their valency shell or orbit. So that is more stable electron configuration. This is one condition, more stable electron configuration. And second statement, the oxidation states are the loss of electron or gain of electron is very less. The oxidation states are not easy to produce. Because of the more stable electron configuration, they never easily lose an electron or they never easily gains electron. When any species atom loses or gains electron, then only it shows its activity, reactivity. So these two are the factors which shows more stable and inert character of 18th group elements. But rarely xenon can react with some selected molecules like fluorine and oxygen to produce xenon fluorides and xenon oxides. So let us have the next topic is xenon fluorine complexes. Xenon fluorine complexes or compounds. What are xenon fluorine compounds? While we are start moving from helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, so from top to bottom, ionization enthalpy decreases. That means when compared to neon, to eliminate electron from xenon, we can use some little amount of energy. So this is the reason why xenon can eliminate, or we can eliminate electrons from xenon. So those xenons may react with fluorine and produces xenon fluorine complexes. Here xenon, by reacting with fluorine, it produces three different types of xenon fluorides named as xenon difluoride, xenon tetrafluoride and xenon hexafluoride. The three xenon fluorides resulting when the reaction expected between xenon and fluorine at high temperature, xenon difluoride, xenon tetrafluoride and xenon hexafluoride. So let us have preparation of xenon difluoride. When xenon reacted with fluorine in excess amount at 673 degree Kelvin of temperature and 1 bar pressure, they produces xenon difluoride. Similarly, when the same xenon when reacted with fluorine, 1:5 ratio of xenon and fluorine reacted with each other at 873 degree Kelvin temperature in the presence of 2 bar pressure or 2 to 7 bar pressure, it produces xenon tetrafluoride as our compound. Similarly, when same xenon directly reacted with fluorine, that is 1:20 ratio of xenon and fluorine, when reacted with each other at 573 degree Kelvin temperature and 60 to 70 bar pressure, it produces xenon hexafluoride. So this is the preparation of xenon difluoride, xenon tetrafluoride and xenon hexafluoride. The same xenon hexafluoride is also produced from when xenon tetrafluoride reacted with dioxygen difluoride, it also produces xenon hexafluoride plus oxygen. So these are the chemical methods which can produces xenon fluoride complexes. So three types of xenon fluorides are available. They are xenon difluoride, xenon tetrafluoride and xenon hexafluoride. So let us have the structure of these xenon fluorides.